Campbell Scientific data loggers make viewing real-time and log data in the field very easy with a simple embedded web interface. The built-in web page is available with any type of IP connection to the data logger, including Ethernet over USB or RNDIS. To access the web interface, HTTP must be enabled. Because RNDIS requires physical access to the data logger, no username or password is required for this connection. The default RNDIS address is 192.168.66.1. I'll enter http://192.168.66.1 into my browser. I now have access to the web interface where I can see the data logger status, access my data files, send new program files, edit the data logger settings, and more. Next, I will demonstrate making a remote IP connection to my data logger to view the web interface. In a browser, enter the data logger's IP address. If I do not know the IP address of my data logger, I can retrieve it through Device Configuration Utility. Open Device Configuration Utility and change the connection type to IP. Click on the Browse button next to the server address line for a list of local devices. If there is a list of devices shown, I'll locate my serial number to get the correct address. By default, anonymous HTTP access is disabled, so I will be prompted to enter a username and password. The default HTTP login credentials are admin for the username, and the Datalogger UID is the admin password. I now have full access to the Datalogger's web interface. See the Datalogger manual for information on ways to edit or set permissions for access. If greater security is required, I can use an HTTPS connection instead of HTTP. In Device Configuration Utility, I will configure security settings and establish access permissions. Select the Network Services tab. At the moment, only HTTP is enabled. Notice the red warning icon next to Security Check. Click on the tab to see the issue. The Security Check results indicate HTTP is an insecure protocol, making it a potential risk. It also recommends using HTTPS as a more secure protocol. It is only a recommendation. The choice of protocols is up to the user. Return to the Deployment tab. If I don't want any IP access to my data logger, including Ethernet over USB, I will need to disable HTTP and HTTPS. For this demonstration, I'll check the HTTPS Enabled box. I immediately get a message at the bottom of the screen warning me the max TLS server connection setting must be greater than 0. This is set in the TLS tab. Click on the TLS tab. My max TLS server connections is currently set to 0. Increase this number to something above 0. I'll select 1. HTTPS also requires additional security provided by a private key and certificate. These typically come from an organization's IT department. I've already obtained my private key and certificate, so I will install these now. To provide read-write access to the web interface, I must set up usernames with passwords. Return to the Network Services tab. Click on Edit Accounts. Click Add User. Enter a name. I'll call this user Tutorial. Note that it is case sensitive. Now click Edit to give Tutorial a password. Set the access level. I'll choose Read-Write. It is recommended that the admin username be changed or deleted completely because it has all access. The admin password defaults to the unique UID given to each data logger. By default, the anonymous user has read-only access. This can be disabled by selecting a level of None. By default, Hide After Save is enabled. This is most secure. I'll switch the anonymous user back to read-only, then apply my setting changes in Device Configuration Utility. Going back to the web interface, I am now asked for a username and password. This is what I just set up in the Network Services tab. I'll enter in the new username and password. Now I have full access to the web interface and can set the station clock. On the data page, variables in the public or status tables that have a blue dashed underline are editable. I can copy stored data to my computer. On the files page, I will need an access level of all to stop or delete a program. For more information, read the user instructions and information, or search our blog post for Ethernet over USB or web interface.